to our channel, Midori and Blaze here. Today we are going to unbox the Witch's Moon for November 2020. As you can tell, I have little things on the table that for pictures because I've actually been spoiled by this, so I know what's in this box, but I haven't looked at anything. Blaze got too excited about the box, and then plus some of my fellow coven mates did videos on these as well. So I'll link their channels down below so that you can check them out. They're awesome ladies. Definitely subscribe, like, and share with them as well as myself. But without further ado, let's get into this. I'm actually kind of excited for this because it's kind of unique. So it comes like this. It also comes in another box so that you can't tell what you're getting in the mail. Sorry, if you hear anything, I do have our animals out here with us and our cats going crazy. So this right here, you'll always get an oracle or a tarot card. And then what's in the, what does yours say? I don't know what mine says yet. Look, I always say I'm innocent.
I got one about love.
Did you?
Yeah, it wasn't depressing this time. It was about love.
Oh, mine's really pretty.
Oh, wow, that's really pretty.
Isn't that really pretty?
I'll have to get
mine
later.
She's that way with me today. So this one is Innocence, and of course I'll put up a picture somewhere around here so you guys can get a close-up of it. It's Innocence, and it says, innocent, purity, joy, you're being encouraged to just be you. Be a shining light for the world. Expect positive outcomes to flow from your honest and pure intentions. So there's this. I'm going to lay this here for now, but I'm probably going to move it because, like I said, I have learned that there's going to be other things. So let's see. So the theme is the witch and the wind. I'm kind of excited for it. So you always get sheets that tell you in descriptive what these are going to be. And then you also, with the witch's moon, get an extra sheet for your own intention, spells, and rituals. So that's kind of cool. I'm going to put that to the side. And let me know down in the comments below, do you like me reading out as I'm going through this? Or do you just want me to like show you what it is and then read at the beginning? Or do you just want me to show the pictures? Please let me know down below. So yeah, I was warned that there wasn't a big picture, but there was like a whole pack. But I haven't gotten to really see what these look like because I got spoiled on it, but I didn't look. So I'm still gonna be kind of surprised. I will, if there's anything on the pictures, I'll try to read those for you. So that's kind of nice. It comes like this, all nice and neat. Ooh. So we got a sigil. I'm going to lay this down. So we're going to put this right here. I'm going to put the sigil right here. So that's really pretty. And then, oh, it looks like we got a prayer or a ritual spell. And again, I'll put it right here. The watchful winds. In buried mounds, upon tethered posts, I call the winds to guide and host. Upon the north wind, the great beyond, may I be granted to access to the astral bonds. Upon the east wind, sure and strong, provide me confidence so my path ventures on. Upon the south wind, within the ancestral den, I ask the connected guide it to how and when. Upon the west wind, the gentle and wise, may my scars be forgiven, to the healing cry. As I let go, as I let live, let my spirit thus weft upon the watchful winds, so mote it be. So it is a ritual spell. Probably shouldn't have read it out loud, but that's all right, because I didn't have anything cleansed, but it's all about intention. So I love the rituals that they give us. I still use the Hecate one every single Sunday when I do my divination work on my Hecate prayer. You've used none of them?
None of them.
Aw.
I need to.
Oh, okay. So these right here, looks like they're all the winds. And so let's go through these. So this one is Eros. And it is the east wind. So that's the east wind.
Isn't that fire?
Yeah, that's fire, it looks like. So I'm going to put that right there.
It's mine.
And then, oh, I like this one. It's a mermaid. Zephyros, and this is the west wind. That is so pretty. And then it looks like this is the south wind, Notus. I like that with all the
its birth, right?
I believe so. Yeah. And then Northrend is Borealis. Oh, that's really cool.
The Northrend is my favorite.
I didn't notice until just now, but there's like a raven or a crow right above his head. So that's really cool. So there's those, and I'm sorry if you can't see them all. I just wanted to make sure they were standing up. Make sure that nothing was glary or anything like that so that you could see all the pictures while we're going through this. So we'll go back into the box now. So we got another little, they've never really had little paper bags. This is new.
Yeah, I loved it. I thought it was so cool.
You liked it? Oh, these are the herbs. Okay. So let me go home for that little paper bag. Let's see what we got. We got chicory. I don't think I have any of that in my apothecary. Linden leaf. And then, what is that word, Savannah? It's those anise seeds. That's kind of interesting because we got full of anise, but she does not like star anise. That's kind of really cool. I'm really excited about that. Sorry, I started looking because the cat is like right underneath my camera. All right, let's see. What else we got in here? Oh, here's our spray. It looks like there's a spray.
Oh.
So, looks like we got a spray today.
Be careful when you try it.
Be careful when I try it. Okay, so it's called Gentle Air Ritual Air Spray. It's not gentle?
It's not gentle.
Mine doesn't smell as toothpaste-y as yours.
Yours does? Wait. Mine smells straight like toothpaste or mouthwash.
Mine smells really good.
Hold up. Just snatch. Without like getting my hand in frame. This smells nothing like mine. This smells nothing like mine. Mine smells like straight toothpaste. That's rude.
Okay, so as I'm putting this in here, I want to tell you guys. So you know how we get two witches' moons? So me and Savannah tend to, or me and Blaze tend to compare the two. And I will tell you this. So mine smells really refreshing and a little minty. Hers smells like toothpaste.
So disrespected me.
I'm gonna spray it and see. Oh yeah, mine smells nothing like toothpaste. Oh my god, that smells so good. Okay, so hers smelled like toothpaste, mine did not.
That's so rude.
So, I like that we get two so we can compare boxes with everybody. So let me go with this. Let's see what else we got. I'm struggling. Okay. The next thing we got is the Four Winds, and it's a lighter oil. And there is a crystal in there. Let's smell this one. Oh, I like the smell of that one. That one's really crisp, too. So just to kind of compare sizes, that's our room spray, and then there's your oil. Let's see, what should we go with next? What's this? They really package their stuff.
That's
deep.
My favorite thing.
This is your favorite thing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So a gorgeous little blue bag. How many of you keep these little bags? I have a whole drawer of these little bags.
Shame.
So we'll put that right there. Let's see what's in this. I have no, so I don't know. Oh, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's so pretty.
I'm sure if you got a bigger one than me.
No, I think it's the same size. I'm struggling opening this stuff though. Oh, there we go.
Nice job.
Mm-hmm. It is a selenite palm stone. So this is my second palm stone. I have one other palm stone, and it's a blue calcite. That's really pretty. Oh, I like that a lot. So that's, oh yeah.
Yep.
I can see why that's your favorite.
Mm-hmm. It's just so smooth.
Okay, so incense is called Remembrance, and I have my Raven thing over there, but I actually am not going to probably light it today just because I have
paper.
Too much paper, fire hazard, plus my household's been really struggling with allergies. Ooh, I like that smell though. Okay, I'm definitely using this tomorrow for my rituals for divination. But there's the membrance. It's like a smoky, woodsy type smell, but it's very gentle. So a lot of the smells I'm getting here are really gentle. Let's see what else we got. We got the ritual salt. Anil? Sacred salt?
I think it smelled good when I smelled it. It's been like a while.
Yeah, she got to open hers first thing. This smells minty too. Now this smells more like toothpaste to me than the spray. Oh, that smells really good, but it's got flowers in it and herbs. I love their sacred salts. So there's that. Actually, let's move this. Lacey wants to go grab her oracle card too. I actually want this deck now.
Shame.
Same. Hers is the Aura of Love. And hers, actually, so this one was mine. So you definitely get different oracle cards. Hers is the unity of light and dark, of earth and sky, balancer of anima and animus, the merger of two souls. Acknowledge the masculine and feminine aspects of yourself, both yin and yang, to create a perfect balance. So that one's really pretty. I like both of ours.
The one's interesting. It's very fitting because I'm gender fluid.
It's very fitting. So that was hers. I'm going to put it to the side, though, since it doesn't come in this box. I don't want anybody to get confused. I think I have the candle here. Now, as you guys remember, last month, our candle for the Hecate box was completely different from each other. So let's see. And I've been pre-warned that there's something on it, so I gotta be careful opening it up.
I love it. There's your gasp for the video.
That's my gasp for the video. It's like periwinkle and there's rosemary all over it. That's rosemary. Uh-huh. And I don't want to like, these big ones do the same thing as the other ones do where you can unroll them, but because it's got that herbs on it, I really don't want to unroll it. So I'm sorry guys. But that is like my favorite blue color. Like I love seafoam green. That's my favorite color in the world. But this candle is my favorite blue. So that is so pretty. I'm starting to think I like pastels.
I'm more pastel person.
Yeah, I'm definitely more of a pastel person. So you can unroll this, put more oil in it. Ritual candle, I love that. Blue is for protection and calming. So I'm definitely gonna use that candle. And then last but not least, the big piece that we always get in these boxes is a wood mount of the wind. I want to read about this with you guys because this is really interesting to me. And like they put the witch's moon on the back with the signature of the artist who made it. And this is like really interesting. We were hoping that they would have different ones like north, wind, north, east, south, and west. I can't think of my directions apparently. But they all look the same. Because Savannah was like, or Blaze was like, if I have a different one, I will give you both. But these are so interesting. And it's wood. It's so pretty. Like, the craftsmanship on this is amazing. It's very light. So I'm going to put that right there. And I want to read about it, so I'm going to keep it up really quick because I want to see what it is. It's a hand-carved wind spirit plaque. There is much wisdom to be gained from the workings with the great and powerful air and wind energies. The lessons learned are some of the hold such deep and intimate meaning to our craft, practices, and perspectives. As long as holding a very sacred place within the magical practices of old, you will find a bounty of wonderful stories that span across the world, capturing the magic and messages that the wind carries upon its back, from the gods and goddesses that control and maintain the severity of storms to the deep and spiritual divinatory practices used to understand the future and what may be coming upon the horizon. As wind is very much associated with the element of air, we work with these energies in the same context, understanding that action, progress, clarity, and transformation play a large role in its practice uses and incorporation. Air and wind brings new ideas and opportunities, washes away confusion, tainting perspectives, brings change to our environment and mental processes that are most importantly facilitated movement during times of stagnation. More opportunities to communicate with spirit, hoping to convey messages and signs to those that are willing and intuitive enough to listen. We have worked to capture the essence of these energies within this hand-carved wood wind spirit made from sacred teak wood. Authentically sourced, this beautiful lightweight wood is often known to live up for 1,500 years, carrying within it its countless messages of experiences and wisdom, whispered to it by the watchful winds. This very plaque has been placed in the process of being created for almost entire 12 moon cycles, resonating deeply with our purest of intentions. It is a masculine form. This wind spirit has been carved to bring momentum to actions you may tend to put off or push away, yet are the most necessary on your path to capture and achieve true manifestation. Allow this carving to remind you to stop and listen, letting go of the cluttered inner conversations and perspectives. The knowledge that is found within the wind that flows around you carries very personal and specific messages. In this wonderful transformation moments, we tend to forget the roles of others and the status quo pushes upon our psyche by those around us. Relax and focus on your breathing. Allow your body to become weightless and your movement to become effortless. As we stated by many throughout time, the winds are changing. We must contemplate that this may mean to our personal path and allow us to connect with the divine energies. We truly wish for this wind spirit to guide and assist you on your very important journey ahead. We urge you to call upon the wind spirits you wish to connect with and ask questions, state your intentions, and say the words of grateful testimony. May the winds push and pull, wind and weave, bestow and let carry on. Ah, so that's a really... That paragraph is really, really, like, I don't know, just
powerful.
It connects with you. This is gorgeous. So this box is their biggest box, but it's actually the middle price box. So it runs, I think after tax for us, it's about $59. But I'll leave the descriptions down below. Thank you again for joining us. This is totally worth the price. I absolutely adore this box. I think they hit it off. I was curious as to what this was when I saw in previous videos. I really, really enjoyed this box. I am going to utilize all of this. So I actually have a place I think I'm going to put those. I'm already like thinking of places to put things. But thank you so much for joining us. Please share, like, comment, subscribe. We really appreciate you guys being on this journey with us. And have a wonderful rest of your day. Thank you again, and blessed be.
I already pressed the button.
If I go, ha ha!
So which is me.
Squeak.
Squeak, squeak.
Baby.
Gotta take my peel.
Take your peel.